Hello, my name is Olivier, and this is your wine rendezvous. Let's start, if you'd like, maybe with a little tour de France of wine so you can clearly visualize what each region is all about, what they mostly make, and so you can maybe navigate through a wine list a bit more conveniently when you go out to the restaurant. So, very easy. Oh, some of you I know are in the USA, so little reminder, this is France, okay? We are based here in Paris. I'll starting maybe with this region here. What is this? This first region is called La Champagne, okay? So if you like champagne, that means it comes from there exclusively, okay? Otherwise, it cannot be called champagne. You're gonna find Cava if you're in Spain, you'll find Asti, Prosecco if you're down in Italy, Sekt in Germany, sparkling wines throughout these English-speaking countries, but champagne is here only, okay? Very easy. Second region, which is right here, is called l'Alsace. L'Alsace, we're right at the German border here. So what do you need to know about Alsace? Alsace, we're looking mostly at white wines, huh? More than 90% whites. If you like Riesling, if you like Gewürztraminer, if you like Sylvaner, Muscat, Pinot Grigio, that we call in France Pinot Gris, Alsace is the way to go. Are they known for making mostly sweet wines? And many people say, Riesling, sweet. I'll try out those dry Alsatian wine, be it the Riesling, the Gewürztraminer. Really super good and frequently undervalued, as people tend to criticize a bit Riesling too easily. So give Riesling a second chance. This region here in red on our map, what is that? That's a region called Burgundy, and La Bourgogne, we call that in French. La Bourgogne, what do you need to know about Burgundy? Are whites and reds, tiny little volumes, super high quality though. Probably, to me, probably the best wine region in the world. Well, names like Chablis, Meursault, Gevrey-Chambertin, Puligny-Montrachet, Pouilly-Fuissé, Mâcon, Claude Vougeot, all these things are in this little area of Burgundy. What do you need to remember about Burgundy? One thing, super easy, white wines, Chardonnay, red wines, Pinot Noir will be our grape. Okay, so if you like Chardonnays and if you like Pinot Noirs, boom, Burgundy for sure. Okay, if you are used though to those big oaky, strong, powerful, masculine Californian Chardonnays or big, super powerful Pinot Noirs from Oregon, from Washington State, from New Zealand sometimes. Don't expect this if you're going Burgundy. Much, much lighter. I frequently compare Burgundy wines to like ballet dancer, very light, very elegant, very feminine. Burgundy. But be ready to pay a little bit. Further south, what's going on? Further south, very easy. It's called a Beaujolais, a tiny little region here. It's only 5% in volumes of French wine. Our Beaujolais, many people tend to assimilate Beaujolais with Beaujolais Nouveau. Alors, it's true, huh? Beaujolais Nouveau, it's a nice little celebration in November, a very depressing time of year. You know, it's gloomy weather, a very short day. So in France, people are very depressed in November. So boom, le Beaujolais Nouveau est arrivé. They go out, get drunk at the restaurant, at the bar. Good fun. The wine, the Beaujolais Nouveau, usually it's crap. But fun night. Yet you find many Beaujolais wines that are not Beaujolais Nouveau. Names like Morgon, Moulin à Vent, Saint-Amour. These things come from Beaujolais, light red wines. Very, very light, very girly, feminine wines. Voilà. No email from the feminists about the girlier market, it's okay. Further south in France, the weather is absolutely gorgeous, okay? The weather is beautiful, so what happens when you go further south? Well, since you have more sun, on the vines, the grapes are going to dry out, okay? Less water, hence more sugar in your wine, and therefore wines that tend to have more power, more robustness, more alcohol, okay? So if you like those big, strong red wines, south is the way to go in France. That's the Rhone Valley here, okay? The Rhone is this river here. Rhone Valley, names like Côte du Rhône, like Châteauneuf-du-Pape, Crozes-Hermitage, Hermitage, okay? All these things were in the Rhone. The big grape there is Syrah. S-Y-R-A-H, that we call Shiraz, if you're in Australia, in the New World, for instance. Voilà. And many others as you go down south towards Châteauneuf-du-Pape, Grenache, amongst others. La Provence, up and coming. You find more and more better wines in Provence. Not necessarily the best value in the world because very touristy region. It's a splendid little region, so the good wines from the area are bought by tourists in the areas. But beautiful. If you got a chance to go visit, it's splendid. Corsica. Nice beaches. Good goat cheese. In terms of wines, you take your own responsibilities. Moving to le Languedoc. Alors, le Languedoc, what do you need to know about this region? Very interesting region. The first vines were planted in the Languedoc more than 7,000 years ago. So, very, very old tradition of wine growing. What happens is that, you know, Africa used to be colonized by France, especially the French used to import a lot of wine from Algeria before the 60s, but then when Algeria became independent, the French was like, we need a lot of big volume wines, not super good, but for our everyday drinking. So these guys took over the Languedoc, they did big volumes, but now they're switching, clearly they're switching towards much better quality wines. So you end up having wines that are extremely good, frequently, if you pay a little more. And powerful. So if you like those big reds, those strong, masculine stuff, Le Languedoc, okay? Le Languedoc is really up and coming. So you find tons of small, cheap, simple wines, frequently called les vins de pays doc. Voilà. But if you pay just a bit more in the US, expect spend, I don't know, more than $10, $12, $15, you will be really surprised by the quality of these wines. Big red, big boys. Southwest, pretty much the same story. Strong, powerful, masculine wines, up and coming, beautiful. It's also the region of foie gras, so good food, nice region, really good. Alors, that leads us to this little region here, Bordeaux. Bordeaux, biggest wine region in France, amongst one of the top ones in the world. Bordeaux wines, oh, that's pretty much the opposite as this wine region. Bordeaux wines are not good value at all, okay? Oh, you find tons of Bordeaux wines, and I'm sure you frequently had the experience of like you buy a Bordeaux wine for cheap, you think it's good value, you drink it, bam, terrible. Bad news. Why? Because huge volumes in Bordeaux. So you find probably the best wines in the world, and you also find the crappiest, okay? Well, not the crappiest, but just very simple wines, which are not really interesting. So Bordeaux, I would say, in France, I would pay at least 10 euros to get a good bottle in Bordeaux at a store. So in the US, you can multiply this by two. I would make it $20 to get something decent. Alors Bordeaux, it's named like Saint-Émilion, Margaux, Pauillac, Pomerol, Saint-Estèphe, Saint-Julien, Médoc, Haut-Médoc, Sauternes. Okay, all these names are fancy sounding, and it's great. They all come from this Bordeaux region. What do you need to know about Bordeaux? Bordeaux wine, something you can remember, is the grapes. The grapes, remember, there's only one grape if you go Burgundy, if you go Beaujolais. In Bordeaux, they're always blended. I mean, it's not one only, it's a combination, okay? So the big grape for the reds is Merlot. You also find Cabernet Sauvignon, Cabernet Franc, Cabernet Franc, as you say. So Merlot, Cabernet Sauvignon, Cabernet Franc. If you like this, boom, Bordeaux is the way to go. In terms of whites, you'll find Sémillon, Sauvignon Blanc, Muscadel. Voilà. The Bordeaux style, since you can only be called Bordeaux if it comes from this Bordeaux region in France, in the New World, to kind of copy and to make these Bordeaux style wines, they came up with that name of Méritage. Okay, Méritage, it sounds kind of French, it's funny. So you find Méritage from Texas, from Chile, from all over the world. Well, it's just this Bordeaux style. Okay, but if you want the real deal, boom, Bordeaux, it helps the French. Winemakers, it's good. Further north, what's going on? Further north, you reach the Loire Valley. Okay, the Loire is this river here. So the Loire Valley are light ones. And we're further north, it rains more, it's a bit colder, we're closer to England, so disgusting weather. Names like Sancerre, like Pouilly-Fumé, those are the big stars of Sauvignon Blanc. And Sauvignon Blanc is the big grape in the east of the Loire Valley. Very fruity, fresh, ideal for an apéritif. Really nice. You find also Chenin Blanc has a grape big time. Chenin Blanc, like in Anjou, in Vouvray. Really good, a bit more mellow. Tons of good rosés as well in the Loire, if you like those rosés. The Loire is a good place to go. And you can also indulge in some light red wines, okay, in the Loire. So we're pretty much done with our little Tour de France. Pretty intense, but might seem a bit complicated. If you want me to summarize it, it's very simple. France, if you like light wines, okay, and if you like them strong, boom, move south. In terms of price, expensive regions, there's three that you all know. A Champagne, a Bourgogne, Burgundy, and Bordeaux. Plus maybe an addition of Sancerre and Châteauneuf-du-Pape. Big names, boom, so you pay a little premium for that. All the rest, super good value and very good. Overall, if you just want a little comparison between French and New World style of wine, French wine tend to be lighter, okay? Less alcohol, a bit more delicate, just like the French. Voilà, I hope you enjoyed this little class, and I would be happy to see you again very soon on winerendezvous.com. Thank you.